Good morning, guys. I hope you guys are safe and at home, isn't it? So, for our previous sessions, we finished the fourth lesson, isn't it? So, for our fourth lesson, what are the topics in electromagnetic induction and alternating current, isn't it? So, what is meant by electromagnetic induction? Whenever the magnetic flux ring with the closed circuit changes and EMF will be induced, the phenomena of producing an induced EMF is called as an electromagnetic induction. Then we learn the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, Lenz's laws, application of eddy current, then we find the solenoid. Self-induction due to lung solenoid, energy associated with the inductor, then we learn mutual inductance, afterwards we learn methods of producing induced EMF, then we learn AC generators, single phase, three phase generator, then we learn transformers. After that, we learn the alternating current. From the alternating current, we learn what support we learn AC with resistance, inductance, and capacitance, then RLC, then we learn the LC oscillation, isn't it? So for our next session, for this today's session, we are going to see our fifth lesson, electromagnetic waves. Okay, what is one electromagnetic waves? So we know that light from the sun is source of our energy, isn't it? Without which we can't survive in the planet, isn't it? So light from the sun is the only source which gives the energy, without which we can't survive this planet. And the light plays one of an important and crucial role in the modern science to understand the concept and structure of one, or from the atom to the whole universe, isn't it? So the light play an important role, and which will be used to understand the structure and the concept from the atom to the whole universe. Till 19th century, the scientists they didn't understand the concept of the optics and electromagnetic waves are the two concepts. After the understanding of Maxwell's theory, he predicted that. What is one? James Clerk Maxwell, he predicted his theoretical prediction that the light is the electromagnetic wave which travels with the speed of. What is one? Light is the electromagnetic wave which travels with the speed of 3×10⁸ meter per second. Okay? So Maxwell predicted that the light is the electromagnetic wave which will be travel with the speed of 3×10⁸ meter per second, because it should be travel with the speed of light. Okay, clear? So from this Maxwell's predictions, we have to find that what is the? We find that the visible rays is the only a small region of electromagnetic spectrum from gamma rays to X-rays, isn't it? So visible rays is the only a small region of electromagnetic spectrum. We know that the electromagnetic spectrum starts from gamma to X-rays, isn't it? From this visible light also, only a small region of electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, clear. So what's the first point? The light. Light plays a crucial role in our daily life, because light from the sun is a source of energy without which we can't survive in this planet, isn't it? Because without light we can produce our food. We can get the right amount of temperature. So how we can survive on this planet? So from this point, till 19th century, the scientists thought optics and electromagnetics are two concepts in physics. After Maxwell's theoretical predictions says that light is the electromagnetic wave which travels with the speed of 3×10⁸ meter per second. Okay, and we confirm that visible light is a small part of our electromagnetic spectrum. What is that? Visible light is a small part of electromagnetic spectrum from the region of gamma rays to X-rays. Gamma rays to X-rays. Then the time varying magnetic field can produce an electric field. So Maxwell thought the understand the symmetry of nature. He thought if time varying magnetic field can produce an electric field, means why not the time varying electric field can produce a magnetic field? Okay. So Maxwell asked the question, because he understand the nature poses the nature of symmetry. Okay, he asked the question, the time varying magnetic field can produce an electric field means, because we learn Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So Maxwell thought that if time varying magnetic field can produce an electric field means, why not the time varying electric field can produce a magnetic field? After late 19th century, let's continue the experiment of Maxwell, and he proved that the light is the electromagnetic wave. He proved that light is an electromagnetic wave. From this, from the experimental result, he proved one of the important inventions like a lasers and radio waves. Okay, clear? So for fourth lesson we see that the time varying magnetic can producing a electric field is when. So if Maxwell thought understand or Maxwell predicted that understand the nature of a symmetry, he thought that if time varying magnetic field can producing electric field means, why not the time varying electric field can producing a magnetic field. So he just predicted that he just makes a theoretical prediction. After the 1958 Hertz proved that, Hertz experimentally proved that we can producing a time varying magnetic field can producing a electric field. What is that? The time varying electric field can producing a magnetic field. And he says that the light is an electromagnetic wave which will be traveling at the speed of 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. From this experimental results, they find that lot of inventions like radio waves and lasers. So today is our model life we are using cell phone, isn't it? Cell phone is an effective tool for transforming information to one to other person, isn't it? So light, it works on the principle of light as an electromagnetic wave. Then hospitals, they are using X-rays to take a cracking of bones, isn't it? X-rays is used to find the tumors or some elements. X-ray is also one of an electromagnetic wave. Then microwave one. We are using microwave to cook the food, isn't it? From which the microwave is one of our electromagnetic waves, isn't it? So the electromagnetic wave will be used in our daily life. So for this session, we are going to see the electromagnetic waves, okay? Clear? So another part of, so for fourth lessons, we learn the time-varying magnetic field can producing a electric field. So Maxwell's thought of this prediction about that, understanding the nature of symmetry. He thought if the time varying magnetic field can producing electric field means, why not the time varying electric field can producing a magnetic field? Okay, so he theoretically predicted that after the 19th century, Hertz experimentally proved that the light is the electromagnetic wave. From this experimental studies, he find out the microwaves and the lasers. Okay, so the electromagnetic wave will be used. We are using electromagnetic radiators. What are examples? First one, cell phone. Okay, everyone is using cell phone, isn't it? So cell phone is works on the principle of light as an electromagnetic wave. The second one, X-rays. We are using X-rays to find the cracking of bones to understand the structure of the crystals, isn't it? So X-ray is one of electromagnetic spectra. Then microwaves or radio waves. Microwaves and radio waves are also one of electromagnetic spectra, isn't it? Isn't it? So from this session, we are going to see the properties of electromagnetic waves and we are going to see the displacement current and Maxwell's corrections to the Ampere circuit law. Okay. So the next one is displacement induced magnetic field.
By changing the magnetic flux
is enriched in a flow. And similar to the expression, what is the Maxwell says that? That's what is Maxwell says that? Our Maxwell's transversion. If the time-changing magnetic field can produce an electric field, means why not the time-changing electric field can produce a magnetic field? Okay, so from this expression, the closed integral of B vector dot dl vector is equal to the closed integral of B vector dot dl vector is equal to minus of d by dt into phi of E is equal to minus of B by dt into integral of E vector dot dl vector. Okay, so here phi E represents the electric flux and d by dt represents the first derivative with respect to the time, and B vector dot dl vector represents the induced magnetic field. So from this expression you can say is that by change the electric field, magnetic field can be induced. What is that? The magnetic field can be induced in a closed loop by changing the electric flux entrenched in a closed loop. The electric flux entrenched in a closed loop. This is called as Maxwell's law of electromagnetic induction. The Maxwell's law of induction. This is called as Maxwell's law of induction. So what is Maxwell's law of induction? What is induced magnetic field? The Faraday shows that, what is that? Faraday shows that by time varying magnetic field can producing an electric field. The time varying magnetic field can producing an electric field is expressed by the expression close to middle of E vector that E vector is equal to minus D by dt into phi of B is equal to minus D by dt into close to middle of B vector that D vector. Here phi of B represents the magnetic flux and close to middle of E vector D vector represents the induced electric field. So from this expression you can say that the electric field will be induced in a closed loop by changing the magnetic flux entrenched in a closed loop. The magnetic field entrenched in the loop. Okay. So from this Faraday's law prediction, Maxwell's consideration was that by Maxwell considered that by changing the electric field we can produce a magnetic field. So from this one he says that the magnetic field will be induced in a closed loop. What is that? The magnetic field will be induced in a closed loop by changing the electric field associated with, what is that? By changing the electric flux associated with the enriched loop. By changing the electric flux associated with the enriched loop. This is called as Maxwell's law of induction. What is that? This is called as Maxwell's law of induction. Okay. The next one is displacement and Maxwell's correction. Okay. What is the next one? Displacement current and Maxwell's equation. So here we are going to find the displacement current and the Maxwell's corrections to the electromagnetic waves. Okay. So considering a consider a situation of charging a parallel plate capacitors in which we have a non-conducting medium. Between the plate of capacitors, we have a non-conducting medium. So consider situations having a charging of parallel plate capacitors. Having a parallel plate capacitor which contains the non-conducting medium between the plates. Which contains the non-conducting medium between the plates. So what's the situation we are assuming? Consider situations having a charging a parallel plate capacitors which contains the non-conducting medium between the plates. Let your IC be the conduction current flowing towards the wire. Let your IC be the conduction, or let this IC be the time dependent conduction current. What is that? Let the time dependent conduction current IC will be flowing towards the parallel plate capacitors, are flowing through the wire of a charging capacitors. So we are by using Ampere law, what is that? By Ampere law, what is that? By Ampere law is used to calculate the magnetic field. What is that? The Ampere law is used to calculate the magnetic field around the current carrying wire. Okay, guys, what is magnetic Ampere second law? What is Ampere second law? The line integral of magnetic field over any closed loop is equal to mu zero times of net current enclosed by the surface, isn't it? So we are going to calculate the magnetic field near the point P, near the wire, or magnetic field at the point of wire near the parallel plate capacitors. So we are assuming a point having a surface. We are assuming, let us consider the Ampere globe having a surface S1 at the point P near the wire. Okay, equation to our data, the closed interval of B vector, that B and vector is equal to mu 0 I c. Okay, so this much whatever point this is done, consider situations of why are charging a parallel plate capacitors contained a non-conducting medium between the plate of a capacitors. Later, the time dependent conduction current IC will be passing towards the wire to charge in the capacitor. Okay, clear? Now, we know that Ampere's law is used to find the magnetic field on a wire or find the magnetic field on a current carrying wire in which constructing an Ampere rule. What is that? Constructing an Ampere rule having a surface of S1 at a point P. So the magnetic field, the closed interval of magnetic field B dot D vector is equal to mu 0 into IC. Then IC represents the conduction current. This will be 1. Then for case number 2, we constructing a balloon safe surface having a surface area S2. We constructing a balloon safe surface S2 will be enclosing on a surface. Both having the same surface, but the shape of the surface are different. Both having the same surface, but the shape of the surface will be different. So by Ampere's equation, we are going to construct the magnetic field at a point P. So what we get? The closed interval of D vector, then DL vector is equal to 0. Why it is 0 means there will be no conduction current. The surface S2 will be no contact or no touching with the current, or there will be no contact with the wires. There will be no current flowing between the parallel capacitor, and it will be zero. So the expression is equal to closed interval of B vector dot DL is equal to 0. B vector dot D vector is equal to 0. But here the Maxwell's corrected the Ampere's equation. The Maxwell's correction says that between the plate of capacitors, if the time varying current flow between the capacitors, what is that? If the time varying electric field between the capacitor means there should be a magnetic field. Okay, so the time varying magnetic field which producing a current, what is that? The time varying magnetic field which producing a current is called as a displacement current. Okay, so what's the point of for the second surface? We are consuming a balloon shaped surface. What is that? Balloon shaped surface will be enclosing over the surface S1, having a surface area S2. Okay, so by Ampere and Blue work, by Ampere's equation, we are used to calculate the magnetic field at the point of P over the surface of S2. The magnetic field, the closed interval of B vector to D vector is equal to 0. B vector to D vector is equal to 0. Why it is 0 means that I can write as equal to 0 because the surface is nowhere touches our result. The surface will be nowhere touches the wire carrying the current, and so also there will be no current between the parallel capacitors. Okay, so Maxwell resolved this inconsistency and he says that the time varying electric field between the capacitors producing a magnetic field which producing a current is called as a displacement current. So the time varying electric field can produce a magnetic field which producing a current is called as a displacement current. So by Gauss's law of electrostatics between the metal plates, what is Gauss's law? The closed interval of magnetic field. The net magnetic flux over the net electric flux over enclosed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 times the net charge enclosed by the surface, isn't it? So what we get? Phi B is equal to closed interval of E vector dot dA vector. So what we get? Phi B is equal to E into E. So if you substitute the Gauss law, guys, what is Gauss law? Phi E is equal to, what is that? Phi E is equal to Q by epsilon 0. So if you substitute this thing, is what we get? Phi E is equal to Q by epsilon 0. So if you have a derivative with respect to the time, is what we get? D phi E by dt is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 into dq by dg. So the time varying electric field and producing a magnetic field which producing a tennis ball is a displacement current. So in the repeat as ID is equal to dq by dt. ID is equal to dq by dt. So if we substitute this one, we get the d phi e by dt is equal to what is that? D phi e by dt is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 into ID. 1 by epsilon 0 into ID. So if we substitute this expression with what we get the ID is equal to epsilon 0 into d phi e by dt. So the time varying electric field flux comes on. The time varying electric field can produce a current. What is that? The time varying electric field can produce a current is called as a displacement current. What is that? The time varying electric field can produce a current is called as a displacement current. Okay. From this answer, when you are going to substitute the Ampere's equivalent law, what we get the Ampere's equivalent proportional law, B vector, that BM vector is equal to mu 0 into I. Here the total current enclosed in surface is equal to convection current plus displacement current. So if you substitute the above expression, is what we get the closed integral of B vector that dl vector is equal to mu 0 into ic plus id. Okay, then multiply by the term is what we get the closed integral of B vector that dl vector is equal to mu 0 ic plus mu 0 into id. Then what side of I will you find? 1 by epsilon 0 into d phi e by dt. So if you substitute this what you get the max of structures in the Ampere's equivalent law, b vector, the dl vector is equal to mu 0 ic plus mu 0 into what we get? Epsilon 0 into d phi e by dt. Okay? Here, between the plates, the conduction current, what is that? Between the plates, the conduction current may be 0. What is that? Between the plates, conduction current may be 0, our conduction current will be 0, but the displacement current is non-zero. What is that? The displacement current is non-zero. So the displacement current can be produced. The time varying electric field. From the displacement current, we can say that the time varying electric field can produce a magnetic field, and the direction of magnetic field will be perpendicular to the direction of the electric field. Okay? So between the two plates, what is that? Between the two plates, the magnetic field will be, zero. Okay, between the two plates, the conduction current, the IC will be zero, but there is a displacement that will be non-zero. So the time varying electric field can producing a magnetic field, which that the direction of the magnetic field, what is that? The magnetic field at any point inside the plate, the magnetic field at any point inside the plate is perpendicular to the direction of an electric field. Okay, clear? So what is displacement current? Considering the superficies of charging wire, a considered situation of charging a parallel with capacitors contain a non-conducting medium between the two plates. Let the IC be the conduction current passing through the wire. IC be the conduction current passing through the wire. By using the Ampere law, which is used to calculate the magnetic field at a point on a current carrying wire. Okay, so we are constructing the Ampere loop having a surface of S1. So by Ampere's equivalent closed integral B vector and dl vector is equal to mu 0 into IC. Here IC represents the conduction current. Now the balloon shaped closed surface having a surface area S2 will be enclosed over the surface S1. Here both the surface having S1 and S2, but the shapes are different. So by Ampere's equivalent we are going to calculate the magnetic field at the current carrying wire. The closed integral B vector and dl vector is equal to 0. Why it is 0? Because the surface nowhere touches the current carrying wire, and also there is no conduction current between the parallel plate capacitors. There will be no conduction current between the parallel plate capacitors. Okay. But there is a difference between the, or there is inconsistency between the two expressions. So from these expressions, Maxwell predicted that, or Maxwell says that the time between the plate of capacitors, that the time varying electric field can produce a magnetic field, which producing a kind of current is a displacement current. So there is a displacement current between the parallel capacitors. So there will be no medium is there. So the time varying electric field can producing a magnetic field, which producing a kind of current is a displacement current. Okay. So from by laws of electrostatics, pi is equal to closed integral B vector and dl vector. From this, by laws of pi is equal to 2 by epsilon 0, second derivative with respect to time, d phi e by dt is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 and dq by dg. We know that dq by dt is equal to id. So d phi e by dt is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 id. From this displacement, the id is equal to epsilon 0 to d phi e by dg. then you are substituting I am by circuit law, and the total current enclosed surface is equal to IC plus ID. We substitute there, multiply by theta. We substitute the value of ID is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 d phi by dt. This is Maxwell's correction of a this is Ampere's-Maxwell's law. Okay, this equation is called as Ampere's-Maxwell's law. Clear? Clear. And most important thing now, between the plate of capacitors, the conduction current will be zero, but the displacement current will be non-zero. So the time varying electric field can produce a magnetic field. And the magnetic field at any point or magnetic field at a point inside the parallel plate capacitors is perpendicular to the direction of an electric field. Okay? Clear? Then Maxwell's corrections. Okay, so what is the importance of a Maxwell's correction? So we know that the light radiation from the stars and sun will be traveled towards the surface, right? So there will be no medium for which there will be no current or no electric field or no magnetic field which carry the radiation towards the surface. But Ampere's law says that the time varying electric field can produce a magnetic field. So there will be inconsistencies now. So the Ampere's Maxwell's correction shows that mu 0 epsilon 0, the displacement of ID is equal to R, the displacement mu 0 b 0 d phi e by d. Okay, so the atoms from the sun and stars which radiate, which emitting the energy, so which producing a time varying magnetic field can produce the time varying electric field producing a displacement current, and also the time varying magnetic field can produce a electric field. So this time varying electric field and magnetic field continuously changing. What is that? The time varying magnetic field and electric field continuously changing, which producing an electromagnetic wave, or which producing a wave, or which producing a radiation is traveled with the speed of light is called as an electromagnetic wave. What is that? The time varying magnetic field and electric field, which will be changes continuously. So the coupled time varying electric field and magnetic field throughout the empty space with the speed of light is called as an electromagnetic wave. Okay? So what is electromagnetic wave? The time varying electric field and magnetic field can continue to travel through the empty space which producing a light with the speed of which travel the speed of light is called as an electromagnetic wave. Okay? Clear? Clear. The next one is Maxwell's equation is integral form. Okay? What is that? We have a four Maxwell's equation integral form. Because electrodynamics can be measured by, what is that? The electrodynamics can be measured in four Maxwell's equations. Okay, four equations. The equation is called as a Maxwell's equation, which will be analogous to the, what is that? Which will be similar to the Newton's equation in mechanics. Okay, which will be similar to the Newton's equation in mechanics. So the first equation is nothing but the Gauss law. So the first equation is nothing but the Gauss law. What is Gauss law? The net electric flux over the sensor. The net electric flux over the closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 of the net charge enclosed by the surface. And so the integral of d vector dot d a vector is equal to q by epsilon 0. This expression is called as the Gauss law. Here the q represents the net charge enclosed by the surface. E vector dA vector expressed by the net electric field changes over the closed surface. Then second equation. This is similar to the Gauss law for electrostatics. This equation is called as the Gauss law for magnetism. Okay, ma? So write the closed integral of b vector dA vector is equal to 0. Okay, well, here for electric flux, the line starts from a positive charge and then it ends with a negative charge. So there will be no closed loop. So there can exist of a mono charge. Okay, there will be exist of either a positive charge or a negative charge. But for magnetism, what is that? There is a continuous closed loop will be there. There will be a continuous closed loop will be there. So there will be no monopole will exist on a magnetism. Okay, then third one is that. Faraday's law of electromagnetic detection. The Faraday's law of electromagnetic detection. So what is the Faraday's law of electromagnetic detection? The rate of change of magnetic flux over the magnitude of induced EMF is equal to the time rate of change of magnetic flux over the enclosed by the closed surface. So what we get out? The closed integral of E vector. The closed integral of E vector dot dA vector is equal to the closed integral of E vector dot dA is equal to minus V by dt into phi B. So here the phi B represents the magnetic flux, the change in the rate of change the magnetic flux producing a electric flux. This will be a third equation as well as a Faraday's law. and fourth one is Maxwell's ambient law. Okay, and the fourth equation, what is that? The fourth equation is Maxwell's ambient law. So here the is the closed integral of B vector. The dl vector is equal to mu zero I c into mu zero epsilon zero d phi d phi d g. Or we can write that the closed integral of B vector the dl vector is equal to mu zero I c plus mu zero epsilon zero d phi d g into integral of A vector the dl vector. Okay. So the Maxwell's four equations, one of important 5-mark questions and also 3-mark questions lastly asked for board exam question. Okay. So first equation is the Gauss law. Second equation is the Gauss law for electromagnetism. Third equation for Faraday's law and fourth equation is the Maxwell's ambient law. Okay. Clear? So for this session we learn Maxwell's law of induction, displacement current, then the Maxwell's corrections towards the ambient law and fourth one is the Maxwell's equations in a integral form. Okay, clear? Okay, thank you.